Now, we all have habits and behaviors that we indulge in that are disempowering to our lives. They're eroding away your potential. They're preventing you from being the person you want to be and having the life that you want to have. And we want to stop that. We want to change and overcome that which what is stopping us and preventing us from having the life that we want to have. And we want to replace that with something new, with a habit, a behavior that's more sustainable long-term, that will allow us to have the pleasure, the satisfaction, the pride, the self-esteem, the self-love, the self-respect, the confidence, the joy, the happiness, and what we want long-term in our lives. Now, here's the thing. Here's how you can identify whether or not a habit, a behavior, a decision that you make, whether it's disempowering to your life or whether it's empowering. It's asking yourself, how do I feel after I do it? How do you feel about yourself, your self-esteem, your confidence, your joy, your life, after you indulge in this habit or this behavior? So what's missing for a lot of people is making sure you prioritize the time each day, first thing in the morning, for you to fill yourself up from the inside out, not from the outside in, but from the inside, where you take the time each day to really cherish yourself, to appreciate yourself and your life, to appreciate all the beauty, all the incredible gifts that have been given to you by your Creator every single day. Because here's the thing, if you're not already right now grateful and appreciative of what you already have in your life, that what you can see and experience around you or within you, right? Because if you're not appreciative of that, then there's no point in achieving more. Because if you do achieve more, if you do get a nicer house or a nicer car or a nicer boyfriend, girlfriend, kids, whatever it is, you're not going to appreciate that if you don't already appreciate what you already got. So what's the point? You got to start first in appreciating what you already have. And sure enough, when you do, you allow the universe to give you more. You attract more into your life with that mindset, with that attitude of gratitude. And whenever you do something that's right, something that's empowering for you, that you know deep down inside, it's good for you, it's good for your future, it's good for the present and the future, you're gonna feel good about yourself. But when you do something that's not good, that you know deep down inside, it was wrong, you violated your rule, your belief, your value, whether it was health and vitality or a goal that you might have, again, you're not gonna feel good about yourself. So how do we change this? If you don't resolve what's going on within you that's uncomfortable, that you're not happy with, then you're just avoiding it altogether, and it gets worse. And it gets worse and worse and worse until finally, eventually, you're gonna maybe feel enough pain that you'll do something about it. So understand this, because really the first step in changing anything in your life is awareness. Awareness. Awareness, guys, is one of the most valuable character traits and skills that you can have. Being aware of your behaviors, your patterns, whether it is disempowering or whether it is empowering. See, a lot of people, they have blind spots. They're not aware of the things that they're doing as disempowering in their life. And most often, they don't want to admit to it. Because most often, a lot of people, they want to convince themselves that by doing this, it's okay. All these things that we have, we believe, we buy into, and we repeat that cycle for the rest of our lives, all the way to the point when I have grandkids, when I retire one day, then that's going to be it. And it's not until you finally realize that this is it, my friends. Right now in this moment, that if right now in this moment you can't find happiness and joy, then there's no other moment in the future that will. Okay, all it will give you is a temporary satisfaction. Okay, you'll have a high from it. You'll feel great for maybe a few weeks or a few months or a few days or a few hours or a few minutes, but it never lasts. And there's always something there that's missing within yourself that you're looking to complete. There's a void that you're looking to fill by these things on the outside, but there's nothing on the outside that will fix what's in here. You know, most of us, we wake up each day, we're in a rat race. Most of our day today or the next day is the same as the day before. They say like 95% of the thoughts that we had today were the exact same thoughts that we had yesterday. You know, we're creatures of habit. We have these habitual patterns that we run. And we gotta knock ourselves out of it from time to time and wake up. And you know, one of the solutions that I found in my life that's really made a difference is really prioritizing time for myself each day. To make myself important, my mind, my body, and my spirit. and to create a ritual, if you will, a morning ritual, where I give myself the most valuable resource that we all have, that we all share, which is time, a depreciating asset. We only have so much of it, but to give that to me, to give that to you each day, to say to yourself that you are worth it, you deserve it, you're more than enough, and you're worthy and deserving of giving yourself the time, because the act of giving yourself time each day is an act of self-love. It's demonstrating that you respect yourself. So I believe we've got to have a ritual each day, whether it's first thing in the morning or in the afternoon or before you go to bed, whatever it is, where you prioritize yourself, you give yourself the gift of time, you nurture yourself, and you fill yourself up and you heal yourself from the inside. And when you do that, you're gonna feel a sense of gratitude, of joy, of happiness, of aliveness, of spirit, unlike anything else. I mean, when I do a ritual every day and I fill myself up, I'm going about the day like flying on a kite, you know, flying on a cloud rather, where I'm just enjoying everything. You know, you build yourself up to level 10 and you're bigger than any problem that shows up. You feel unstoppable each day, right? A lot of people, for example, they're kind of going about the day half full or half empty, and they're looking for all these things to fill them up, all these outside things to fill them up, instead of filling themselves up first. Everything that you're trying to get from these external materialistic form out there in the universe, you can already experience the emotions right now without having to achieve them. Right now, you can experience so much love and joy and happiness without having to have a partner in your life, without having to have kids, without having to have more money. All of that, you can experience right now. You have it within you. You have the power to experience it. All you gotta do is to choose to focus on it. Whatever you focus on expands. You attract more into your life.